I've received a lot of requests lately for a video review of the Well MB08. I received my Well MB08 from airsplat.com. The rifle retails for $158.99, using the coupon code AS4LIFE, qualifies for free shipping. They have this gun in both black and tan versions. I know a lot of you may have had bad experiences with Airsoft before and in the past, but over the last couple of years I've ordered several things from them, and I've never had any problem with shipping or customer service, so I continue to order from them. My package arrived 4 days after the initial order. Upon receiving the larger outer box, I opened it to find a plain brown box with no markings on it whatsoever. The box was slightly damaged in that it had a couple of depressions from where the sling mount and the stock catch were slightly elevated above the styrofoam packing. In the box comes a rifle stock, rifle barrel and bolt assembly, 2-point sling, standard issue pack of BBs, scope with rings, BB speed loader in the 90 round M9 mag style, Allen wrenches for disassembly of the rifle, an adjustable bipod, 125 round magazine, which is also compatible with the Well MB01, the Well MB05, and most Type 9.6 rifles on the market, and an unjamming rod. While the sling mounts are metal, they are very cheaply made and have tendency to break under the weight of the rifle. I don't recommend using the sling. You should probably purchase one that's a little more sturdy. The BBs are the standard issue pack of 0.2 gram BBs that come with most airsoft guns. I recommend throwing these away and not using them. Speed loader is pretty standard. It comes with the magazine adapter, which makes it a little bit easier to load the rifle magazines, but I don't usually use these or recommend people use them, as they usually just get lost or broken anyway, so you should figure out how to load it without it. The bipod has adjustable spring tension legs, which will adjust out an additional 1.5 inches. The total length with the legs extended is 10 inches. The paint on this chipped off and flaked off pretty well, and it wasn't too high quality. It seemed a little stiff when adjusting it into positions, but use will loosen it up a little bit. The scope is a generic 3-9x32mm scope with 1-inch scope rings that mount to a Weaver-style rail. While it is nothing worth writing home about, it is a fairly decent scope considering its intended application. The scope is non-illuminated with standard crosshair. It has a 2-2.5-inch eye relief, and while there is no parallax adjustment on the objective belt, it has both windage and elevation turrets. Also included are amber-colored see-through lens caps. The Well MB08 has a great initial feel to it, and it follows suit with all other Type 9.6 rifles in that it has an ergonomic grip that is very comfortable to hold. The stock is plastic, but it has a very dense, solid feel to it that is unlike the Well MB01, which has more of a cheap ABS plastic feel to it. I cannot actually see any added weight to it. There may be some in the stock somewhere, and while it is lightweight, it is well balanced and does not feel front or back heavy. A couple of negative things that stand out to me is that it has a very obvious seam line that extends the entire length of the stock on the bottom side of the gun. It also has a nice Made in China painted on the left side of the stock in front of the trigger guard. Additionally, the magazine catch on the barrel was loose and needed to be tightened. Overall, I was very impressed with the quality of this gun. With its balanced weight and ergonomic body design, it is very comfortable to hold and very easy to shoot. Even though this gun is the typical Type 9.6 style, it has many features on it that separate it from other guns of the same style that are out on the market. Some of the features are small ones, while others are large enough to make this one of the best Type 9.6s out there. Firstly, the folding stock. The stock folds midway through the grip. It is very solid when extended and locks very tightly to the body of the gun when collapsed. It shortens the length of the gun a total of 10 inches from 45.5 inches in overall length to 35.5 inches. It has metal sling attachment points on both sides of the stock so that you can sling the rifle while collapse and extend it. To collapse the stock, there is a solid metal push button on the top of the hinge point that depresses to make the stock fold. This feature makes the rifle very compact and easy to sling to your back or store in a small compartment. Another new feature is the monopod. The monopod is on a spring tension release. To deploy it, one needs to simply pull down on the desired height and it locks in place. It retracts by depressing the bottom plate at the base of the monopod. This feature is great while on target for long periods of time, and it helps stabilize the rifle while shooting. Another feature is the adjustable cheek rest. To me, this was poor design and poor execution on the Well MB08. While I was initially excited about the adjustable cheekrest, I was very disappointed in this. On the right side of the gun, there are two adjustment knobs, one of which fell off while I was adjusting it. The knobs are nothing more than a bolt that tightens through a threaded collar inset in the stock. These two bolts press up against two skinny plastic pieces that are attached to the bottom of the cheekrest. It is not a levered or gear style adjustment. Simply loosen the bolts and pull on the cheek rest, then tighten the bolts down to keep it in place. It is very flimsy and not very reliable. It feels as though I'm going to snap the cheek rest when tightening the bolts. You are better off just leaving it in its lowered position. Should you choose to use the cheek rest, it adjusts up around 1¼ inches. Some other smaller features are that it has an integrated Weaver rail, a removable Weaver rail front block for mounting the bipod and accessories, a fluted outer barrel, and a two-stage trigger, which requires both triggers to be pulled to fire. Before any of you naysayers think, what do you expect, it's a well, or it's a Chinese piece of junk, I want to state that I initially purchased this with the intent on completely replacing the internals. In fact, I had all of the aftermarket parts before the gun even arrived. With that being said, this thing internally is a piece of junk. I know most reviews try to put a positive spin on things, but I will not sugarcoat it. If you are not planning on upgrading the internals and want some decent performance, then get something else. When I first took the gun apart, I looked at the barrel and the hop-up. When I removed the barrel, there was only one flimsy little piece of warped rubber acting as a barrel spacer. Most stock rifles have these little barrel spacers, but I've never seen only one in a gun before. The stock hop-up is usually a decent build and design. Mine was actually broke. The hop-up control arm is plastic and kind of weak. When I removed the hop-up adjustment collar, I noticed that the control arm was cracked almost all the way through. It took very little to break it the rest of the way off, which makes me think that it would have happened fairly soon. This is not good, considering I've only fired around 80 shots. I tested its stock performance before I pulled the rifle apart. The shape of the control arm is its highlight. The piece that applies pressure to the bucking is in a U shape that resembles an H-nub for an AEG, which allows it to get a nice, even backspin on the BBs, allowing it to be able to get some pretty straight trajectories on 0.43 gram BBs in its stock configuration. The barrel is the standard 495mm brass, non-type bore barrel that comes with most airsoft rifles. It was fairly straight, clean, and is decent as far as stock barrels go. The bolt and cylinder assembly are well made. The cylinder is stainless steel with a brass cylinder head. The stock cylinder head is non-tapered but has the high airflow design milled into its base. This is nice as this used to be an old school trick to grind the cone shape into the cylinder head for a small FPS boost and a little better consistency. The spring guide and piston are the same plastic ones that come in the Well MB01 and the Well MB05. The trigger assembly is definitely the weakest link in this chain. It comes in an all-plastic housing, which is typical. When I first attempted to attach the bolt assembly to the stock, I noticed a large bump of plastic on the outside of the trigger housing. After examining and finding out that it serves no purpose other than to cause the gun to not assemble correctly, I ended up grinding it off. My guess is that it was the largest casting flash that I've ever seen. After opening the trigger housing, it appears as though the piston sear and the trigger sear are both either pot metal or very strong plastic. They are not heavy enough to be stainless steel and are non-magnetic, but they are not light or weak enough to be plastic. I assume that after I upgrade that they will not last very long and snap once the 190 spring goes in. The safety catch and trigger are both plastic, and the spring guide stop is metal. All performance testing was done with the gun in its completely stock configuration and before I disassembled the gun. The MB08 chronographed very well. It had a range of 5 FPS and averaged 398 FPS with a lowest value of 396 feet per second. This was nowhere close to the 450 feet per second that was advertised. The target range was 150 feet for all accuracy testing. The target had a 12-inch diameter with an inner ring with a diameter of 6 inches. The temperature outside was 50 degrees Fahrenheit, a relative humidity of 60, and there was no wind or rain present. The BBs used were 0.43 gram BBs from Airsoft Outlet Northwest. Overall, on a 12-inch target, the MB08 shot 70%, meaning that 70% of the shots fired hit within the 12-inch ring, 40% of which scored in the 6-inch inner ring. Overall, it was an 8-inch grouping. This was probably because of the one flimsy barrel spacer, broken hop-up, and the non-type bore barrel. You won't be threading any needles, but if you happen to find someone standing out in the open in front of the broadside of a barn, you will be guaranteed to hit something. In summary, some of the pros for this gun are it has a solid, sturdy plastic stock, it's well balanced, it's got a decent scope, ergonomic design, a collapsible stock, and an adjustable monopod. For the cons, the made in China stamp, seam line, broken hop up, poorly designed cheek rest, bad casting, plastic trigger components, and flimsy barrel spacers. Despite the new external features, the Well MB08 falls way short when it comes to stock performance. This gun is a great platform to build on and is capable of being a great airsoft bolt action rifle, but it will require some money to get it there.